I love all of the jokes where people are like, oh, I left my mask in the car, and it's lesbians going to grab their mask girlfriend. But the joke doesn't work when you're Australian because, yeah, mask. Yeah, mask works. But the one that goes over your face, that's a mask.
I'm happy to announce that I have officially reversed the effects of heteronormativity on my mind, and I now find it gross and discomforting when people are straight in my vicinity.
Friendly reminder to take your hormones, and remember, never touch estradiol with your hands or you'll grow hand titties. Yummy, delicious hormones.
How's your girl, man?
She left me.
Oh.
Yeah, my mom died too. And my dad got deported. But I got the van.
It's nice.
Yeah, right?
Oh, let's play Never Ever Have I Ever.
Oh my god, you can't play that because they might find out that you're...
We could just play cards. I'll go Mikey, I'll go first. Or Mario Kart, I can get my Switch and set it up, it'd be fine. Never ever have I kissed someone.
Someone? She didn't say whether it was a girl or a guy, so they don't need to know that it was a guy. I can just drink.
Well, you both know Mary. What about you, Chris? You've taken a drink.
Oh, shit.
Oh, come on, who was it? It was a girl from holidays in Spain. A Spanish girl, yeah, right. What was her name?
Paul.
Paula. Hey, fair enough, Paula. I'll go next. Never ever have I ever had a crush on someone in this room.
I could just drink. Mikey doesn't need to know that it's him.
I never knew you had a crush on me, Chris.
I don't.
But you took a drink, so if it's not for me...
I mean, I don't like you, I love you.
Oh my god.
Thank god, because I thought you meant me when you drank.
No, just Hannah.
Because that's why I drank, because I like you.
Oh my god, really? Because I really like you and I suppose this is my coming out and I really didn't know what to say because I didn't know what you felt.
Chris, I'm joking.
And me too. No.
Here is a reenactment of an interaction I had with two drunk men outside of Chinatown at 3 a.m. Also, I was in drag coming back from a gay club.
What are you doing up? Where have you been off to?
Oh, I was just at a gay club.
Ah, you're a bloke, you're a bloke. You're dressed up as a woman.
Yeah, I'm a guy.
Ah, oh, he's a very pretty man, is he?
Yeah, he's a very pretty man.
Are you part of that, LGBTQ?
Yeah, that's right.
Aye, you're a very pretty man.
Thank you for watching.
LGBTQ plus, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Why?
Because I'm gay.
For a bunch of 6-year-olds, I think the decor looks great. The PTA did this.
Oh, okay.
Where's my son? He's on Voguing over there. DJ, I thought you looked familiar. Yeah, I know you from the club. And I know you're a barb, and I saw your set list. Baby Shark, not gonna cut it. Don't let them suppress you. Say Dancing Queen. Dancing Queen. If you saw him tonight, you would know that he needs jazz and tap dancing. Your date said you out? Sorry, yeah, no, first grade's rough. He's cosplaying as Elsa tonight because he wants to be more like us. Isn't that cute? Yeah, I just let him wear what he wants. Yeah.
That's not organic.
You have enough room for Gaga.
Yeah. Mrs. Johnson, I'm having an after party just for like a few cool parents. You should come. There's gonna be belly dancing and a nice luge.
She made fun of you? Which one? That one right there?
Honey, she came for you because she can't pull off Tool like you can.
My cat is gay and he can tell what your gender identity is. By that I mean that my cat only humps men, whether that's trans men, cis men, or kind of trans masculine non-binary people. He will not hump cis women, trans women, or other non-binary people. And that is regardless of the main sexual hormone that is present in their body. So if my cat can tell that gender identity is a thing, then gender identity is a thing. Contrary to some TERF's beliefs, it's not some kind of magic soul thing that has no impact on reality, because even TERFs don't believe that the trans lobby is able to brainwash cats.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Emily. I'm a Leo. I have childhood trauma. I have a weird relationship with my father. Like, he's here, but he's not. You know what I'm saying? He's there, he's here, and he's there. Yeah, I am 23 years old. I was born at 1:37 p.m. What else can I tell you? One time when I was little, I scraped my knee really hard, and I was like, I'm a lesbian. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, did you know gay people? That's us.
Yeah, I just wanted to thank you for being such a great ally.
Ally?
To the LGBTQ plus community. Thank you so much for all your efforts and for constantly learning and working on yourself.
I've got a gay. Go. Go, I've gotta go.
You know, when I was a kid and anyone would ask, like, what's your least favorite color? I'd be like, orange or pink. Or really just orange and pink together. I hate them together so much. Worst combination of all time. So ugly. And now I'm a lesbian!
Every now and then.
Oh, Miss Mohammed, me and Nadia are actually gonna go out to DC tonight. Oh, and I'm gonna sleep over at Sanji's house tonight.
Okay. No, just take care of my daughter, okay? And she knows.
Hi, I'm just a really good ally. Ignore that.
Yeah, I just wanted to thank you for being such a great ally.
Ally?
To the LGBTQ plus community, thank you so much for all your efforts and for constantly learning and working on yourself.
Egads, touch me not, lest you be struck.
Hey, whoa, I got a problem here. My hands are empty, and I'm not getting any kisses. You want to solve that for me?
Day in the life of a non-binary art teacher is Friday. Let's get it.
What's up, Mr. Waves?
What's up, Teacher Robbie? How are you?
What? You gonna go back to class?
Mm-hmm.
And you gonna do your work?
Mm-hmm.
Sound good to me.
5 seconds to be in a seat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you to everybody that's in the...
Wait, Amaya, what'd you say just now? You said what?
Yeah, you famous.
I'm famous.
You are famous.
I'm famous.
Yeah, you're famous.
You want everybody for you,
Paige.
Yeah.
I love y'all so much. Things like this that make me want to do videos like...
Before you finish, stay. This could work out. I really think this could work out. I don't think that my vision's blurred now. I want you, please pull your mini skirt down. I don't think this'll work out.
Like a one-year-old. We did gloves, so your hands aren't dyed.
It's angel food. It's angel food cake and Cool Whip. I don't think that's how they would put it in their mouth.
No, it sounds cool.
Who is it?
Andrew.
Oh. Jupiter, eat some. Oh my gosh. Put some in your mouth.
Who's cool it?
Is it good?
No.
Leandra, what's the gayest thing about you?
I flew to LA to see a girl and she ghosted me.
Matching tattoos.
1 year into dating.
I married a girl 3 months after knowing her.
Definitely my walk. I broke my foot skateboarding.
Ah yes, the four genders. Girly girl. Tomboy. Boily boy. Gent.
I think it's extremely fun that I'm a lesbian and I realize that I'm in a handsome relationship. Like, look. Two handsome dykes.
Oh my god, wait, you look like an angel.
I just finished crying, so let me see if I can put my thoughts into words. I just found out that being asexual does not mean that you don't desire sex and that you never have sexual feelings. It just means you don't experience sexual attraction towards another person. So you can still have sexual feelings. It's not directed towards anyone, if that makes sense. Same with aromantic. It doesn't mean that you're incapable of having deep emotional connections with someone. It just means that those deep emotional connections are platonic rather than romantic. And that's how I feel about literally everybody that I'm close with. And like, I have never looked at someone and thought, I want to have sex with you. That doesn't happen. When I get sexual feelings, it just happens. Like, something might turn me on, but it's never directed towards a certain person, if that makes sense. And what sucks is, except for my best friend Tia, I am unable to have those deep platonic, almost soulmate level relationships with people because there's always the romantic or sexual expectation that comes along with it. Now that I know this, I will be bringing this up with my therapist on my next session, and any future potential partner, I can now communicate how I feel more accurately, because before, I was really fucking confused, and I know that I really fucked up one relationship because I wasn't able to accurately express how I was feeling because I was just so confused in my head. And if she's watching, she knows who she is, and I'm very sorry.
Yo! Someone's watching She-Ra down here!
Sorry?
Someone's watching She-Ra down here!
I'm on my way from misery to happiness to be.
I'm usually called Ted Coyle or Professor Coyle. Either one of those are good for me. My pronouns are they or he, if you fall back onto that, but I prefer they.
There does exist a pink kryptonite in the comics. One of the strangest things in Superman comics, pink kryptonite makes Superman gay. Isn't that the weirdest?
That's offensive.
Yes, incredibly.
That's offensive.
I know. There's a reason we're talking about this here.
Yeah. How do they know that?
When Superman is around pink kryptonite, he loses all interest in Lois Lane. He becomes extremely interested in Jimmy Olsen. And then also in some not great sort of stereotypes, he also is very complimentary of Jimmy Olsen, the window treatments that Jimmy Olsen has.
So when was this one written?
Was that
2003?
2000.
Will and Grace was on the air.
Oh my god!
What are you talking about?
Wow!
I thought you were gonna say 19.
Actually, that is enormously offensive.
Can we be ourselves, huh? Why can't I be me? Are you ashamed of us?
Very.
I know I'm not the only person who thinks that cishet men are just like different things sometimes. They will violently hump each other in public and like moan and turn around and go, no homo, and say something homophobic.
And
That's the thing about illicit affairs and clandestine meetings and longing stares. It's born from just one single glance, but it dies and it dies and it dies.
I hope one day I can be like fully comfortable with my gender, but until then, I will always have this little voice in the back of my head harassing me constantly. Like, I 100% pass as male. If you think otherwise, you need glasses. But when I do things that are like completely normal for a male person to do, this voice in the back of my head is like,
yo, what? What the hell are, stop. What the hell are you doing right now?
And I'm like, what now? What do you mean?
Do I need to say it? You're shirtless. You're shirtless right now in the men's locker room. Oh my God, you are a freak.
I don't see the big deal. Like, I've had top surgery. Like no one's even in here. It's empty right now.
Oh, it's empty. It's empty. Oh, what happens when a bodybuilder waltzes in here and just smashes your skull against that wall over there?
They probably wouldn't even know that I'm trans.
And what if they ask about your top surgery scars?
I'd probably say I had like lung surgery or something.
Lung surgery, right. Right, that's why you're at the gym, right? Exerting energy, breathing heavily, right? Put your shirt back on, you freak. You disgust me.
Closeted or in denial teenage trans man starter pack calling y'all out. It's just really supportive.
I've learned just one thing. I don't think that's who I'm supposed to be.
I'm cold.
Turns out I'm trans as fuck. And yes, life has been rough, but all of the bullshit's made
it's comfy. Men's jeans have larger pockets.
Faking every day makes me go insane. I felt nervous.
I'm not LGBT. I just think we should respect everyone.
I think one of the funniest comments I get is whenever I talk about homophobic experiences or homophobia in general, there's always like a couple straight dudes. They just come in and they go, "That's cap, bro." Y'all, homophobia is not even like present anymore. Like, it's fucking 2021. Get over it. I wonder, Brandon, I wonder why you've never faced homophobia. I wonder, Brandon, why you don't think it's prevalent. Could it be that you are a straight boy from the Midwest? Perhaps. Dude, I never see homophobia. Brandon, you're wearing basketball shorts in the winter. Nobody's gonna hate crime you. They know. They know you're straight.
Relax and enjoy a healthy dose of prolonged eye contact.
Wait, let Batty buy a card.
It's a fucking lesbian.
Did you guys have fun at the museum? Hannah, what was your favorite? Warhol? Basic. Bye, Hannah. Nice seeing you. Yeah, tell your parents that I said, nice lawn. Cornelius, I'm gonna be honest. Hannah just seems like the type of girl that, like, listens to Kidz Bop by choice. Your mom's calling. Cornelius, hold the wheel. Hold the wheel. Hi, sexy. I missed you, too. You heard what last night? Oh, that's just mommy and I practicing for the MMA. Yeah, it's not violent. We're just really scared. What? Shut up. Shania Twain just tagged you in an Instagram post. The more Shania Twain that you listen to, the gayer you get. Can you see us?
Shania Twain here.
Ah, hi Shania. You should not be allowed to drive. You might think that you're straight now. I thought I was straight at 6 years old, maybe. So just give it time. Do you have room in your schedule next Tuesday to see Susie? Because Wilson's keep bothering me. Yeah, you need to show face because I need the tea on their divorce. Hi, Mrs. Johnson. Are you coming to my party tonight? Yeah, don't bring your husband.
Something that I don't think I talk about at all is the fact that I am asexual. To me, it's not really a big deal, honestly. But I just figured out, like, a lot of y'all don't know that about me. Yeah, I have come to that conclusion almost every single time I got out of a relationship. I'm like, yeah, I'm definitely ace. And then when I'd start a new relationship, I would just pretend that I didn't come to that conclusion and, like, start the process over again. But yeah, the more you know. And, like, I'm so aware that, like, asexuality is a spectrum. I just happen to be on the side where, like, I could live the rest of my life with, like, never having sex again. It doesn't really matter to me. And, like, I still do get H-word, like, I'm a human being, but, like, it's really just, you know, spin the tracks and then move on. Yeah. So, like I said, the more you know.
I have one thing to say. You better work, bitch.
So I'm at the point in my transition where I don't pass perfectly, but I pass just enough that transphobes are too scared to call me on it. I've been in bathrooms before where people are like, I think that's a tranny, but I can't risk it. That's my plan if I ever get called out. Some lady's like, you're in the ladies' room. Be like, I am a lady. How dare you? How do you like that, America? I'm playing 3D chess on your ass.
You know, I thought My Chemical Romance turned me trans, but apparently it started even earlier in my life with...
Have you heard of the hanky code? It was a secret fashion code that gay men used in the 70s and 80s to communicate what kinks they were into and whether they were a top or a bottom. Some say it dates back to cowboy times where a lack of women meant that men had to dance both parts of the square dance and would use a bandana to signal which one they were dancing. But the meaning as we know it is attributed to a writer in the Village Voice, who joked that the community's current code of wearing your keys in either pocket to signal whether you're a top or a bottom should be updated to a coloured hanky, which would also communicate what kind of thing you were into. Leather stores and bookshops grabbed onto this and published decoder guides to help men out crew. In essence, tops wore their hankies in their left pocket, bottoms in their right, and every colour hanky meant a different kink. This practice declined during the late 80s, as did anonymous sex due to the HIV/AIDS crisis, but still exists in some circles and is an important sartorial bedrock in queer history and culture.